In the UK, we have got such an incredible width and breadth of music scene. We're punching way above our weight in like the world music stakes, and there's such a rich scene in every single genre.
We've hooked up with Levi Support Music Project to make films with the likes of Michael Kiwanuka, Lower Than Atlantis, and Lady Leisure to talk about the importance of access to music for artists and their communities.
When you travel around the world, do people talk about the UK music scene as something that's quite special?
Well, in America they do a lot, yeah. You know, for soul music. So even when you're like my level, you go over there, people are like, man, and you're doing interviews, people are like, what is it about England, you know?
It's so weird to think that UK music acts sort of compete with somewhere like America that's just so vast.
People look to get their inspiration and nick things from England.
We're cool, aren't we, for some reason? Like,
the way that you listen to Eminem and Missy in your room writing rhymes, kids your age then are doing that to you now.
Not only am I an artist that don't swear so they can listen to it around their family and stuff, but I'm bringing something new to the table. I'm doing things that people are not doing. I'm breaking barriers, you know. It makes other people realise it's possible. If you keep doing what you love, eventually you're going to break through.
But for that to keep happening, we need to make sure that we support our music scene and give opportunities to young up-and-coming artists to help them develop.
Where did it all begin?
I was like year 7, there was a band in year 9 at the time, and they were performing some tunes. But it was a few, like, heavy rock trio, and I'd never heard like electric guitar like that. I remember going home that day and saying, Mum, I want to get a guitar. And there was just a culture of bands at school, and so that was the first time music really hit as a, I want to do this.
Yeah, Ben was in a band called A Boy Called Hero, which is like a pop punk band. And I filled in for a while, and then when that sort of disbanded, we started this band. And then here we are, 10 years later, really. Oh, wait, and then these guys.
Yeah. we were in a band.
Feeling the love there, yes. Yeah.
I was a bedroom MC. I was just writing lyrics. But there was a youth club not far from my house, and I'd go there every day after school because they'd have the facilities, they'd have the equipment for me to record myself and learn how to produce and learn how to mix and master. So I'd done it all at a young age, which I'm so thankful for that youth club. And in a way, like, I feel like there needs to be more youth centres for that to happen for other young kids, because that's getting them off the street, and that's something I'm really passionate about.
What's it like starting out? Did you think about becoming, you know, big in the Watford scene and then sort of branching out?
The thing with Watford is there's always been like a really healthy scene for us as like kids growing up and stuff. But if you want anything enough and you work hard for it, you're gonna get it.
Do you think you had like a bit of an easier ride being from London?
Way easier. You're like, venues are just like a bus ride away. You could do any style of music. Like, if you were into jazz, there were like jam sessions. If you're into like rock and roll, you could just go to Bullet, to the Camden with Bath Ride. It's harder now, and there's just less venues as well.
Do you take a lot of pleasure in bringing people up or helping people up?
100%. I don't know if it's because I'm from Birmingham, but a lot of Birmingham people, we have that heart.
You look after each other.
We look after each other, we do. When you're in the media and you're in the public eye, you can become a role model. That wasn't something that I thought would ever happen to me, because I just was in my room writing lyrics and just going to the studio and recording it. I never thought I'd get that title to my name. But at the same time, I'm honoured.
We do kind of have a policy that the opening band, if we can make it work, is like a cool band that we like or that we think are coming up. That's kind of a thing we always have, if we can make it happen.
Once we had like Jake Bugg supporting me, and like about 2 months later, I was supporting him. Yeah. Sometimes you get that, but that's also really cool, you know.
Why is it you think that it's important to nurture the young talent?
Fresh perspective to the same thing is always important. So a younger generation is always going to do things in a way no one's ever seen it or looked at it or approached it, which helps the music progress and helps the music get better.